drop it. Smash it. Crash it. That's the way. Every day you can play Beat the Clock. And now here's the star of the all-new Beat the Clock, Monty Hall.
Hey, thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Well, it's nice to be back on television, and it's really nice to be back with the best stunt show of all time, Beat the Clock. It's a great way to start off your day. Lots of stunts, lots of good humor, lots of fun, lots of pretty girls. And we're the lucky ones, because we've got them. Thank you, kids. I want you to meet Lisa over here, and we've got Autumn, and then we've got Cindy. And you'll see a lot of them on the show. See you later. Well, what can I tell you about Beat the Clock that you don't already know? Two teams play against each other in stunts, and then, of course, they play against our famous clock. That's the one right over there. And if you can beat the clock, you can make a lot of money on this show. And there are two couples just dying to make some money, so let's meet them, Jack Nahrs.
Okay, Monty, on the red team, we have Gary Capata, the number one girl in his life, Sue Steiner. And, Monty, these are newlyweds over on the green team, David and Jerry Jacobson.
How long?
4 weeks.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
That's very nice. Where are you kids from?
Long Beach.
Uh-huh. Where are you from originally?
I'm from Connecticut.
And she's from?
Indiana.
Now, I always have to ask a question. Nobody starts from here. They always come from somewhere.
Great.
Nice to have you here. And what do you do for a living?
I'm a consultant for a small company.
Well, she's going to consult you on how to do the stunts later on. Maybe we'll find out more about Jerry as we go along. I see two different names here, Gary Capata and Sue Steiner.
Right, how you doing?
And I guess that's your best gal, huh?
Right, sure is.
I should, there's limited questions I can ask you in a case like this, you know. But so let me just switch right over to what do you do?
I work for a large CPA firm, and so does Sue. Same firm, in fact.
CPAs?
Yeah. Right.
Tell me, okay. Is she a deduction?
She's a credit.
Oh, very good. Very good. Hey. Not nice to be funnier than the MC.
I'm sorry.
All right, gang. Looks like this is going to be a lot of fun. Four great kids are going to start the action now with a stunt that pits the ladies against each other. The winners will get $500 to start their scores rolling. So, ladies, come with me, and we're going to make some hamburgers. You like that? Come on over here. The lady, the green, is on this side over here. The red is on this side over here, right behind the table. One on the opposite side facing the other. Come right back to the beginning, because this is going to be the beginning for you here. We're going to make some hamburgers. Do you like hamburgers?
It's the best meal I know how to make. The only meal.
Did you hear that, Gary? The only meal she knows how to make. And Jerry, how about you?
I can't cook.
You're at a decided disadvantage in this game because you're going to cook me a hamburger because I have all the ingredients laid out for you here. See that plate down at the end of the table? Well, I'm going to ask you to make me a hamburger by taking the bottom part of the hamburger, placing it on the plate, coming back, getting the meat, putting it on the hamburger, come back at the onion, come back at the pickle, put the top of the hamburger on top, and the one who completes that first, I want it all like that, nothing slipping off the sides, the one who completes it first or is leading when time runs out will be the winner. All right? The time allowed for this stunt is a full minute. Oh, and one other thing I should tell you. We're very sanitary around here. We don't let anybody touch the hamburger. So you're going to do it by placing this in your mouth.
Oh, no.
And that's right. And placing your hands behind your back. Are you ready? Get set. Go. You don't have to slide it. You can pick it up if you like. Look at how fast they're working. It's upside down. Your butt is upside down. Look at this. Hold it. That's it. Good. Look at you lost your bun. You lost the bun. That's it. Get it back. Get the meat on top of it. Not bad. Not bad. Slide it over. Keep it going, Sue. Keep it going. Poor Jerry. Jerry, you gotta get it on the bun. All right, all right, all right. And she got it. Stop the clock. Yes, 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 we'll have to accept it. You little sloppy, but all of it was on, and it all stays together. So the winner is Sue Steiner. $500. Let's go back to the boys. You'll never get a job at a hamburger stand. Listen, you not only won $500, but what's more important, that earned you the right to work together on a stunt now, and you both can be competing against our clock to get another $500 and double your total up to $1,000. So are you ready to go into that? Yeah. You got your breath back?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right, we're going to play a little game that involves cups and balls. Bring them out, and let's find out what the cups and balls are all about. Now, folks, join me out here. Now, I want Sue to stand right about here, because you're going to be throwing the balls.
Oh, good.
And Gary is going to be catching them. Gary, you come on over here with me. Because what I want you to do is, see, I want you to bounce the ball, Sue, and Gary, I want you to stand on the mat, and I want you to catch them. You see? What's the catch? Why, how could you think of such a thing? The catch is this, that you have to catch two balls, you see? And what we're going to do, she's going to bounce, you're going to catch, and you're going to have to do it within the time limit that we have for you, which is... The time for the stunt is a very nice, comfortable 45 seconds. Now, you're going to have to catch them not in your hands, but in cups. Can I have the cups, please, Autumn? No, 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 no. These cups are for when the queen comes to tea. I want these cups over here that are slightly different, as you can see. There we are. There we are. I want you to hold them at the extreme end. Can you get at the extreme end? That's it. The very end, right over there. That's right. Get the straps over here. All the way down at the end. Have you got it here? That's it. Marvelous. Now, all you have to do, of course, is when she bounces the ball, you catch one in each cup, right? And you'll turn around with your back to her. And you can't turn sideways to see where the ball is, but you can go all the way back like that and follow the ball. One in each cup. In 45 seconds, and you got another $500. Are you ready? Start bouncing, Sue. Oh, don't hit it. Bounce down. Down, down, here. That's it. That's it. Put your head back. Watch it. Here you go. You got one. Come on. One more. You can do it. You can do it. Just one more. Here. Oh, close. Here. Here it comes. You got it. Quick. Got the reach on it. Oh, so close. 20 seconds left to go. A little far, Sue. Oh! 10 seconds. Three, two, one. Oh! Isn't that too bad? I thought you had it because you got the first one in such fast time, but you didn't get the second one. Gary and Sue, you don't get the extra $500, but not bad, not bad. Now, I tell you what, that's just the beginning. We have more to come on Beat the Clock, and we're coming up with more stunts, and then we'll have the men lock horns for more money right after these commercial messages. So far, the team of Gary Capata and Sue Steiner, the red team, have $500. The green team still waiting to get their first amount of money. And now it's the men's chance to try for some dough. So Gary and David, come up here to the starting line. This is the starting line. And we're going to play a little game. I hope that you're in great physical condition, both of you. Because it's going to take a lot of good, deep knee bending. Are you good at that? I'll put one box behind the red team, one behind the green. Now it is your job to take this box and transport it across the finish line right over here. And when you do, come back and get a second box and do the same thing. And the person who can deliver two of those boxes across the finish line first will be the winner, or if he is leading by the time runs out. The time for this stunt is... a nice, circuitous 1 minute. All right. Now, how do you think you'll transport them across the line? Not the way you were thinking. You can't drag them across your feet. Girls, bring out some special apparatus. Here we have some belts from the Spanish-American War, I think, which will wrap around your midriffs. Hanging behind the belt is a rope, on the end of a rope, a ball. The ball is going to pull the basket across the finish line. You see that? Only by getting the ball in the basket will you be able to transport it downstage. I'm going to move you over just a little bit to make a little bit more room. Okay. Now, don't start until I say go. No use of hands. Just squat down, get it, pull it, come back, get the second one. If the ball comes out of the basket, you got to come back and retrieve it, right? But no hands at any time. Are you ready? Remember, you have to come back for a second one. Get set. Go. Off to a fine start. Hey, David's off to a little lead. David has a lead on Gary. As soon as he gets it across, no, come back, get it, got it, get it. Now the trick is to see how they get it back in. No hands, no hands. He's got it. David's away. David's on the way. Now here comes Gary. It's going to be a close race with 30 seconds left to go. Gary's left the box. David still got his. Coming, 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 coming. And the winner! Stop the clock. Well, that is a tough one. That's a tough one. When you have to go with those knees bent in that position, oh, you have to be in good shape. Look, Gary's out. He's on. All right. So the green team is back with us and wins $500 for that event. Good. Now, if you can catch your breath, David, and I'll give you a long time, like 3 seconds to do so, you and Jerry will now work together to get another $500. Great. Just about ready for it, you think?
You bet. You bet.
Good. All right. This time, we're going to play a game that we call Hanky Panky. Let me show you what hanky-panky is. Come with me over here. Not too far, because I'm going to have to throw a ball in the air. So the two of you stand right about here. I will show you how to use a tether ball, as if you didn't know, but in case you didn't, I will show you how. A tether ball, you take at the very end, by letting out a little bit of rope at a time, you can make wider and wider circles, right? Until you've got it really going. And that's what David is going to do. That will be your job, David. So come on over here, David. You will stand on this mat, and you will wind that tether ball and throw it round and round and round. And what do you think you're going to be doing, Jerry? You're going to be in here in the barrel. Come over and sit in the barrel with your back to David. Sit right down in the barrel with your back to David. Comfortable? Now you see a box of handkerchiefs. You will take these handkerchiefs one at a time, not more than one at a time. You'll throw it straight up in the air, above the height of the barrel, so that David, in spinning his tether ball, can capture one on the rope. Now, what you have to do is get two of these in the time allotted. Have to capture two to be able to earn your $500 in the time that we have for you. May I also remind you that you have to make one complete revolution with a handkerchief on the rope, at least one revolution for it to count. Do you want to try one handkerchief for me, dear? You have to throw it a little higher than that, or he'll never get it. He'll never be able to reach it. Well, that's not bad, but just don't throw it back over his head or he'll never get it either. I would suggest straight up and try and get it about this high, okay? David, I won't start the clock until you have reached the circumference. Let's see how much time you have for this stunt. Time on the board is 50 seconds, and you have to get two, and I'll let you know when you've got one. Are you ready? Start making your circles. I won't start the clock until you get right over the top of that barrel. Let out a little bit more shaft. Little bit more, little bit more, little bit more, little bit more. All right, ready? Go! No, no, he's making one revolution. Keep going. Oh, make big circles, David, make big circles. You still got time on that clock. All right, here he goes. Here he goes. Throw him up high. Good at high, Jerry. Throw him up high. He's got one. He's got one. And you still have 20 seconds. You still have 20 seconds. You just need one more, and you've got it. All right. All right. Now, you see, even though you're going to have to pay for a new barrel, you kept sucking that barrel pretty good, David. But you had lots of time, and you've made a nice comeback and got two of them, and you get $500 more. Your total is now $1,000. And, my dear friends, both teams will be back for the bonus shuffle to determine who gets the chance to win up to $10,000 right after these messages. Well, we're back now. We're back, and we're going to play the bonus shuffle. As you guys can see right now, the bonus shuffleboard is divided into areas ranging from $300 to $4, to $5, $6, $7, $8, $9, $1,000. And I must tell you, that, of course, that The one whose disc is touching the highest amount of money when you finish the game is the person who will win and win that amount of money and then play that bonus game for 10 times the amount. So if somebody should, let's say, hit 800 and win, you'd be playing the bonus for 8,000. 1,000, you'd be playing for 10 grand. That's a lot of dough. I should also like to tell you that if your disc goes all the way through and off the board, it's worth nothing. We'll remove it. Same thing if it goes off the side, and same if it doesn't go as far as the first number. So you have to at least touch the first number, okay? Now, here is something for you to consider. Because the green team is leading by a score of 1,000 to 500, they get an advantage in this game. They will have three discs to throw against the red team's two. All right? So, green team, ladies first. Jerry, you're going to be the first one. I'll go down at the end of the table and let you know how you're doing. Jerry goes first. Sue, you'll be next for the red team. Here goes Jerry, the first amount. Looks like a pretty good throw. Look at this. All right, now listen. It's touching 900. Now, you know what you have to do, Sue? You've got to do something either better or knock it off. Here it is. It's worth $900. Sue, the first shot for the red team. She's coming up. Will she touch it? She did. She knocked it off the board. Okay, David. Now, take a look at the way things have changed. Now, the red team is touching 900. David's got to do something about this. Here it comes. Good shot. They're both off the board. Now we're down to just one disc each, and it comes down to a fighting finish. Gary, you got an open table to shoot at. All right. Gary is touching 600. Gary's at 600. Who's going to take the last shot? David says, all right, I'll take the last shot. Now, here's what you've got to beat. You can either slide it past or try and knock him out. Let's see what happens. He tries to slide past, and he didn't quite do it. The Reds still nose him out. The Reds nose him out. Whew, is that a close race? All right. Okay. Which means that the red team gets $600, and in just a few moments we'll be playing a bonus game for 10 times 600 or 6,000 bucks right after these words. Miner have earned the right now to play our bonus stunt for 10 times 600 or $6,000. And here is your bonus stunt. Three pins. You see the way they're standing up so nicely and neatly? I want them like that when this stunt is finished. And the reason I want them like that is because I'm going to knock them down right now, and it'll be your job to get them right back the way they were. And the time for this stunt for $6,000 is 45 seconds. And one more thing. The only thing you can use is your feet to get them up. Your feet together, right? Now, face each other right over the first pin. Put your hands on each other's shoulders. And when I say go, using only your feet, you go. Ready? Go. You got to get all three. They're off to a start. Let's see how they do. This is for $6,000. You got 30 seconds. You've got one. Let's see how they're doing. Look at this. Look at this. I think they've got... Oh, close, close, close. And... All right, you got two. And 15 seconds. They got two. They got 15. They got 10 seconds for $6,000. They got five, four, three, two, one. Oh, my dear Gary and Sue, so close and yet so far away. They got two, didn't get the third. We'll come back and say goodbye to these kids in just a minute. Jacobson have to leave us with $1,000, but that's not bad for day's work. Thank you for being with us. You're a wonderful couple. The Jacobsons, $1,000. Now, Gary and Sue, you come back tomorrow, and you'll be trying that same bonus stunt if you're the winners, because it keeps going until somebody learns how to do it and wins the money. You picked up $1,100 for today, and tomorrow you meet a brand new couple and maybe even play that bonus stunt. So let's see how the two CPAs do when they come back to meet another couple on Beat the Clock tomorrow at the same time. Bye-bye, everybody. See you tomorrow.